Okay, the next question. See, the find the value of young for E. For which? First one, find the value of young. So you have to find the value of young in this question. So 5 power young. The question is given 5 power young divided by 5 power minus 3 is equal to 5 power 5. So now, in this, the first one, see, 5 power m divided by 5 power 3 is equal to 5 power 5. So now, can you find the answer? Can you find the value of m directly? So now, the question is in the form of, see, here in the left hand side, 5 and 5, the same base. So, in the law of exponent, if you know the law of exponent, you must learn the law of exponent before solving all these kinds of sums. A power m into a power m can be written as a power m plus n, and a power m divided by a power n divided by base same, power different. So we must use a power m minus n. So the second law, a power m divided by a power n. So that is what the question is in the form of second law. So second law is a understood a power m divided by a power n form, because same base power is different. Clear? So now what is a? A is a 5 and power is m is m. What is n? N is a minus 3. So in place of n, the value is a minus 3, and m we don't know, that we have to find out what is the value of m. Clear? So base is same, 5, 5. So we can use a second law of exponent. The second law of exponent says that a power m divided by a power m is equal to a power m minus n. This is a second law. The question is in this form, so you must write the answer a power m minus n form. So what is a? A is here 5. So 5 power m means m is a n is a minus of minus 3. Why minus of minus 3? Because in the formula, although it is given minus of, but n, the value of n is a minus 3. So write inside the bracket. Clear? You get two negative signs, then you should write inside the bracket. Okay? 5 power m minus of minus 3. Okay? Now simplify 5 power m. See, you have to remove the bracket in the next step. So multiply the sign. Multiply minus into minus. You know, minus into minus a plus. So value is a 3. So 5 power m plus a 3. 5 power m plus 2. Now this is what left hand side the answer we got, 5 power m plus 3. So what is given in the right hand side? The right hand side value is given 5 power 5. Is it correct? Only we simplified left hand side, we got answer 5 power m plus 3. And in the right hand side, the value is 5 power 5. So 5 power 5 is in the right hand side. Now, see, if you compare left hand side and right hand side, see, the value is in the left hand side, 5 power m plus 3. And in the right hand side, it is already given in the question. Okay? We simplified left hand side. Right hand side, it is given 5 power 5. Now what is the question? We want to find the value of m. We want to know the value of m. So how we can find? If you compare the power, if you compare the base is same. Is it same? 5 is a base. Here the 5 is a base. So which is the power? The exponent. Exponent is a m plus 3. And here it is a 5. So if base is same, then we can compare the power. Understood? We can compare, we can see the exponent. So now we can write m plus 3 is equal to 5. Because the base is same in both the sides, then we can write, we can compare the exponent on left hand side and right hand side. The exponent is here m plus 3, and the exponent of 5 is a 5. Clear? M plus 3 is equal to five. So now you can find the value of m, isn't it? So m is equal to, what is the value of m? M is equal to 5 minus 3. Plus 3 will go to another side, then sign will change. 5 minus 3. So 5 minus 3 is 2. So therefore, the value of m is Therefore, the value of m is 2. Clear? First step, see the question. The question is in the form of second law of exponent. So, write in terms of a power m minus n. A is 5, m, write as it is, and sign minus n value is minus. So, negative, right? So, write inside the bracket. So, now m minus of minus 3 means m plus y plus a multiply the sign. In the next step, you have to remove the bracket. Okay? Minus into minus, we get plus, and m plus 3. 5 power m plus 3, that is what? Left hand side answer. And the question is given that right hand side value 5 power 5. Now, if you compare both left hand side and right hand side, the base is same. Is it correct? Huh? Base is 5 and here base is 5. So, base is same. So, we can compare the power. Okay, right? M plus 3 is equal to 5. That is what exponent of a left hand side and right hand side. Because base is same, so we can write like this. Therefore, M plus 3 is equal to 5. So, we can say that M is equal to 5 minus 3. 5 minus 3. So, this 5 will be in the same place. And see, plus 3 will change into minus 3. Understood? Plus will change into minus. So, now, therefore, M is equal to is equal to 2. So, the value of m is 2. Understood? Yes. The next question. Okay, we solve now. The next question is evaluate. Evaluate the first one, that 1 by 3 power minus 1 minus 1 by 4 power minus 1 whole power minus 1. Clear? 1 by 3 power, this we have to evaluate. So, the question is 1 by 3 power minus 1 minus 1 by 4 power minus 1 whole power, it is given, that is minus 1. Whole power is a minus 1. Now, see the question. 1 by 3 power minus 1 can be written as, you know that a by b, a by b whole power minus n means, that can be written as a b by a whole power n plus n. Clear? A by b whole power minus n can be written as a b by a the power plus n. So, like that, 1 by 3 whole power minus 1 can be written as a 3 by 1. Okay? 3 by 1 whole power 1 plus 1. Minus, it is given in the question. So, write as it is, minus sign. Next, minus, see, 1 by 4, the exponent is minus 1. 1 by 4, the power is minus 1. So, this also is in the form of a by b whole power minus n. So, that can be written as b by a, the power is a plus n. Okay. Now, we write 1 by 4 can be written as a 4 by 1, the power is minus 1, whole power is given, that is also minus 1. Okay. 3 by 1, power 1 plus a, okay, the negative is changed into positive, right? Plus. So, 4 by 1, power is 1, whole power minus 1, whole power of minus 1. Now, simplify, 3 by 1, you know that 3 by 1 means that value is 3, is it correct? Yes, 3 power 1, 3 power 1 is 1, so 3, clear? 3 by 1, it is 3, the power is here 1, unit of Friday power 1, so next minus. So, 4 by 1 means that is 4. So, what is the power of? Power is 1 if you want, right? Whole power is minus 1. Whole power is a minus 1. So, 3 power 1. 3 power 1 means 3 minus. That means 3 power 1 means how many times you multiply 3? 1 time. The answer will get 3. Similarly, 4 power 1 is a 4. Whole power. Whole power is a minus 1. So, now simplify, 3 minus 4, so what is 3 minus 4? 3 minus 4 is minus 1, 4 minus 3 is 1, and greater number is 4, 4 is a greater than this, and sign is a minus. So, minus 1 whole power minus 1, So the exponent of this minus 1 exponent is a minus 1. So this can be written as 1 by minus 1. Understood? The question is in the form of a power minus 1. A power minus 1 means 1 by a. So like that, minus 1 power minus 1 can be written as a 1 by minus 1. So now, if you simplify, you get plus a 1 by minus 1, the sign is minus, 1 by 1, that is a 1. So the answer we got minus 1. Understood? The question, you have to evaluate 1 by 3 power minus 1 minus 1 by 4 power minus 1 whole power minus 1. So now, this term is in the form of a by b whole power minus n. So that can be written as a b by a whole power plus n. So like that, we can write 1 by 3 can be written as a 3 by 1. So here minus 1 will change into plus 1. Clear? So minus 4 by 1, same type of 1 by 4 can be written as 4 by 1, power is 1, whole power is a minus 1. So now 3 by 1 is 3, 4 by 1 that is 4 and power is a 1. If you want to write, the next step you can simplify. Whole power minus 1. Next term, 3 power 1 that is 3 and 4 power 1, 4. So what is 3 minus 4? 3 minus 4 is a minus 1. So minus 1 whole power minus 1. Simplify. See, minus 1 means a power minus 1 can be written as 1 by a. So 1 by minus 1 is a minus 1. Okay. The next question. The second one. See, evaluate 5 by 8 whole power minus 7 into 8 by 5 whole power minus 4. So the question, see, if you observe this question, the base is here 5 by 8 and here it is a 8 by 5. So we can write base 5 by 8 and 8 by 5. So if it is same, you can use the law of exponent. So can you change one term? If you change, if you write the inverse term, so it will be same, isn't it? So here it is 5 by 8 and here 8 by 5. So one term you can change. That means 5 by 8 whole power minus 7 is in the form of a by b whole power minus n. A by b whole power minus n means b by a whole power plus n. So like this you can write. If the question is like this, a by b power minus n, that can be written as b by a power plus n. Okay? So now, 5 by 8, the 5 by 8 can be written as a 8 by 5. 8 by 5 power minus 7 change into plus. Is it correct? 5 by 8, 8 by 5 minus 7 plus 7. Okay? Now, into 8 by 5 write as it is. Because if you write as it is, we get the same as base. The base is a same. 8 by 5 and 8 by 5 is a same base. What is the power? Power is a, what is the exponent here? Minus 4. So now 8 by 5 into 8 by 5. See, the base is same and here multiplication sign and power is different. So we can use the first law of exponent, isn't it? The first law of exponent says that a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. A power m into a power n means a power m plus n. So now, so what is a? A is here 8 by 5 and m is 7. A is a 8 by 5 and n is a minus 4. So now you have to write like this, a power m plus n. So 8 by 5 whole power plus 7 into 8 by 5, the power is minus 4, can be written as a power m plus n form. Is it correct? This is a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. So what is a? A is a 8 by 1. What is m? m is a 7. Clear? M is 7 plus plus what is n? N is minus. So write inside the bracket. If it is plus, no need of writing inside the bracket. So the sign is minus. So write inside the bracket. So what is the answer? 8 by 5 the whole power. What is the 7? 7 plus into minus. What is plus into minus? Minus 7 minus 4. 7 minus 4 is a 3. So answer 8 by 5 whole power 3. So this is the final answer. If you want, you can simplify like 8 power 8 by 5 whole power 3 means this is the power to go. 8 power 3 and 5 power 3. So the next question, 8 power 3 means how to multiply 8 3 times and 5 power 3 means multiply 5 3 times. Okay? Now, you know that 8 8 see if you are multiplying this sum. 8 power 3 means 3 times, 5 power 3 means 3 times. Now multiply. Multiply 8 into 8. 8 8 sum 64. 64 8 sum. 64 into 8. 8 4 is 32. The remaining 8 6 are 6 8 are 14. 8 plus 3 it is 51. So 512. Is it correct? 8 4 is 32. The remaining 4, 8 4 are 8 6 are 48 plus 3 51. So 512 by multiply 5 to 5 to 5. 5 5 is a 25. 25 5 is a 125. So the answer is 512 by 125. So 512 by 125 is the final answer. So if you evaluate this, you get this answer. Here, practice, write and practice in rough code.